You may be seated. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
God bless you. We're here tonight to celebrate, to join these two together. They want to hear words from you of encouragement. Words like we're praying for you. What they don't want to hear is your advice. Amen.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Shall we pray? We desire our Father to acknowledge thee in all our ways, that you might direct our steps. Especially do we seek thee in this point in our lives. Graciously regard these two servants who come before thee to assume the mutual obligations involved in marriage. May they walk not heedlessly, but in the fear and in the solemn steps which they are about to take. Assure them and us of your presence. Let the beauty of the Lord, our God, be upon us as we celebrate this marriage. We humbly ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Marriage is God's first institution for the welfare of the race. In the quiet bowers of Eden, before the forbidden tree had yielded its fateful fruit, or the tempter had touched the world, God saw that it was not good for man to be alone. He made a help suitable for him and established the rite of marriage, while heavenly hosts witnessed the wonderful scene. Originated in divine wisdom and goodness, designed to promote human happiness and holiness, this rite is the foundation of home life and social order, and must so remain till the end of time. It was sanctioned and honored by the presence and power of Jesus at the marriage of Cana in Galilee. It marked the beginning of his wondrous works. It is declared by the apostle to be honorable in all things. So it is ordained that a man shall leave his father and mother, cleave to his wife, and they too shall be one flesh, united in hopes and aims and the sentiments and the interest of this present time. I understand a couple have their vows. Thank you, thank you for
it. Not forever love, which is in these last names, when we met, for already. Wherever without my tender crush will become my forever love. Say I swear by first, and I say it was you, but no matter what, God knew we were destined for the day. I just want you to know that I'll forever cherish you. Continue to embrace your weaknesses and strength, that's been your night and shine on. I promise to continue to learn everything about you, how to quit the words I forgot, my forever best friend. I will love you unconditionally without you, not having to say a word. I promise to love you to the death of me and even after that. I promise to embrace every goal you have in life and to make those attainable. I promise to continue and forever protect you and King you. Also being the best example of Mr. X, or one's dad, or I promise to be your devoted husband as you think you can. Cherishing and promising to strive to always keep you happy and laughing all the time. I promise to respect and honor you and never to dwell on differences you face going forward. I promise to speak words of life over you and listen thoroughly and patiently to all your needs and desires. I promise to see our marriage every morning. I wake and every day I live. Through the good times and bad times, I'll always be right there. I know how big of a queen bee fan you are. You know, teeny bee hobby. And I put me in those, obviously, she's not here. But you can't say queen without the cue, and that's you for you. My queen forever and ever.
From our second date when you stretched your hand across. table and prayed for our dinner and for our date, I knew you would be the man I would marry. You immediately made me feel comfortable and like I could be myself. You accept me and love my daughter, now our daughter, as your own. You allow me to be my dramatic self, but also call me out on my dramatic moments here. Those are just a few of the many reasons why I love you. Today we start this new chapter of our lives, and I'm so grateful to be committing to spend our life together. As I wrote these vows, I thought about how I want to spend the next 60 plus years and the things that I want to promise to you. I promise to wholeheartedly commit myself to you and to hold sacred this covenant we are making before God. I promise to cherish your strengths and to be a supportive wife by allowing you to lead our family. I promise to work together as a team to resolve any conflicts that we will face and to choose our marriage every day. I promise to listen to understand your position instead of listening to respond and to choose my words wisely so that they are received with an open heart and mind. While on the subject of choosing words wisely, I promise to say the in front of the Ohio State.
If then Xavier and Daquisha have freely and deliberately chose each other as partners in this holy estate, and know of no just cause why they should not be united, in token, please join your hands as you have. Xavier, in taking the woman you hold by the hand to be your lawfully wedded wife before God and the witnesses present, you must promise to love her, to honor her, and cherish her in that relation, and leaving all others, cleave only unto her, and be to her in all things a true and faithful husband, so long as you both shall live in your promise. Daquisha, in taking the man you hold by the right hand to be your lawful wedded husband before God and the witnesses present, you must promise to love him, to honor him, and cherish him in that relation, and leaving all others, cleave only unto him, and be to him in all things a true and faithful wife, so long as you both shall live in your promise. Then you are each given to the other, for richer for poor, for better for worse, in sickness and in health, till death shall you part. The rings. As a ceaseless reminder of this hour, and of the vows you take it, place that ring on the right hand of your bride and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. With loyal love, I thee endow. And all my worldly goods, with thee I share. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Take that ring and repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
With loyal love,
I thee endow.
And all my worldly goods,
with thee I share.
In the name of the Father,
the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Shall we pray? We thank thee, O God, for the providence which brings hearts into bonds of human love, so like the love divine. Accept in heaven thy dwelling place, the union of the hearts which are before us. Grant the ties which bind these two servants, may they grow stronger with passing years. May they trust each other with perfect confidence, and together trust in thee for guidance and in help. It's in the name of the Father we do pray. Thank God, and amen.
Amen.
We'll read Ecclesiastes 4, 9 through 12. It reads, two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one lifts up his fellow. But woe unto him who is alone, who fails, and has not another to lift him up. Again, if two together keep them warm, but how can they keep one alone? And though a man might prevail against one who is alone, two will withstand him. A threefold cord is not quickly broken. The part where I know that Matthew is anticipating, but we're not quite there yet. I have what I call words of wisdom. I know that you've had counselors. I know that they taught you well. But just a few things along the way that hopefully at some point in the quietness of the day, tomorrow, the next day, you'll remember and live with them. The first thing that I talk about is communication. It is the lifeblood of any relationship. Sometimes he's going to make you angry. Take a moment, take a deep breath, take a day. But make sure you come back together and communicate. Find out each other's love languages and let that cup run over. I learned a poem years ago. It's called The Four-Chambered Heart by a lady by the name of Denise Min. She says, "The love never dies a natural death. It dies of wounds and of errors and of betrayal. It dies because we don't know how to replenish its source." My grandmama would say something like this: "Xavier, whatever it took to get her, it's going to take the same thing to keep her. Keep dating her, keep loving her, grow together, and you'll win." The last thing is, make Christ the center. Make him the focus. Make him the head of your house. Only allow what he allows into your soul. Amen.
Amen.
This was for free. Don't let anybody tell you about your marriage. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
They'll try to tell you about the situation they had with their old man, and you see where it's gotten them. Amen. Allow God to be the center. Let him lead. Let him guide. When you have a question, and you too don't know the answer, I challenge you to ask God. Lean on Jesus, not mom and dad. "For as much then as Xavier and Daquisha, having covenanted together according to the teachings of the scriptures and the laws of the state, I, an officer of the law and a minister of the gospel, to declare that they are husband and wife, what therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. You may now seal your vows."
Thank you.
grab your neighbor's hand. Grab your neighbor's hand. We're going to have a quick word of prayer. I've got a quick announcement, and then we'll move on. Eternal God, Father, we thank you for this couple. We believe that you guided them together. Lead them, guide them, bathe them in your Holy Spirit, so that the aroma that comes from them is sweet smelling to the nostrils of Jesus. We do love you. We thank you. It's in the matchless name of Jesus Christ we pray. Thank God and amen.
Amen.
Very quickly, a quick announcement. I need the immediate family to stay here. I need the immediate family to stay here. You can, in fact, sit down. The immediate family to stay here. I need these guys going out. Sorry. And as soon as they leave, you guys can exit out. They have what they call a cocktail hour.